plant people, my name is Svetlana. I am from Firefly in the Room, and today I want to talk with you about easy to care plants. So in YouTube there's lots of videos and internet, there's lots of articles about easy to take care plants, right? But what I usually see that there's lots of videos or articles about almost always the same plants. Usually when you are looking for an easy to take care plant, they are like pothos, jade plants, zizi plants, what else we have? Sansevierias or mothers-in-law tongue. Sometimes I see cacti as a very easy to take care of plants and etc., right? And to be honest, I got a little bit bored of them because, you know, I actually believe that people want to grow more various plants and more different plants, not that common plants. And maybe sometimes people are a little bit afraid to try because they don't want to hurt the plant and don't want to kill it. So I will try to open your eyes. Just kidding, I'm not such an expert about plants, but I'm growing about 100 right now and all of them are alive. Well, two died last week. But that's another story. I want to see people to grow more different plants, more various plants, and that's why today I decided to film a video about easy to take care of plants, but I won't add any of those plants like peace lily, zizi plant and others that I already told you, and I will talk with you about little different plants, and maybe they're not as usual as they should be, but we'll try to work on that. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Do it. Okay, so the first plant I want to talk about is this euphorbia. And this one is kind of a funny story. I don't know if you have been looking my previous videos on YouTube, but as you may know, I am pretty lucky about plants because in here in Lithuania lots of people in Springle tried to get rid of their plants, but they didn't throw them away in the trash bags or garbages or trash containers. What they did, they left them outside, they left them near containers, they left them in parks, and I was the one who found them. So this euphorbia is the first plant that I saved this year, and it was on February, and it's actually kind of a funny story because in February it's cold in Lithuania, it's minus temperatures usually, and it's still snowing in there, but this year, I don't really remember, but I'm pretty sure there was already no snow. And one day I was walking my dog Rocky, as usual, and I saw a broken pot and something green near it. So I ran straight away to this place and I saw these beautiful euphorbias that were thrown away from the window. I don't know how that happened, maybe that was an accident or maybe it was on purpose, but somebody just threw them away out of the window. Wait. So what I did, I panicked a little bit because there was three euphorbias, and so I grabbed this one smaller one and ran straight away home because I was a little bit scared and confused what people will think, how would they look with this kind of plant while I'm taking it from somewhere, I don't know. I was just confused, scared, and I just ran away home. And why I took this one, because it still had leaves and it looked pretty healthy. And this one had like one or two leaves, I don't remember, and it was all broken down because I'm pretty sure that all the hit from falling took hard on this one, and so it doesn't look very happy. And the small one were already frozen and its leaves were transparent, so as I was pretty sure it is dead. So I took this one smaller plant home and I sit there for like 2 or 3 hours and something inside told me, come on, go there and save another one. Why just saved one if you can save two of them? come on, this one, bigger one, didn't do anything wrong. She deserves a chance. So what I did, after like 3 or 4 hours, I took Rocky and we went again for a walk. And went to the same place and found it. It was still there, nobody took it. So I took this one home too. And after a day or two, I potted them in this pot. And for sure, this one got much more stress. So she threw away all of its leaves. It was naked, bald. And this one had maybe like 3 or 4 leaves after all. And well, I wasn't sure that there is a big of a chance because it was freezing outside, but there they are. And this one actually is blooming, smaller one. So I think that's a good sign, right? So talking about care of this euphorbia, it's so easy. I mean, this plant will show you when it needs water, because I tend to overwater my plants. But with this one, it's so much easier because I never overwater this one. Because when it's happy, when it's full of water and doesn't need anything else, its leaves is very healthy. They're thick and straight, and it's showing that I don't need anything. I'm just fine. Leave me alone. And actually, when it needs water, its leaves start to get wilty. They just fall a little bit down. And show me like, come on, I need water, wake up. So it's so easy with this one. And actually, you can see one leaf is burned down. It's an old leaf from the older plant mom. So probably it stood on the full sun window and it didn't like it. So what I did, I am holding it in my kitchen. And there is north window, I guess, and it's totally fine. It's growing new leaves once again, and it's still growing and growing, and it's blooming and it's happy. So if you want a plant that it's easy to water because it tells you when it needs water, that don't needs full sun and is happy with low light conditions, this is the one. And it's very easy to pot also because it doesn't have that huge roots. And I just potted it in cactus soil and, well, here we are with a happy plant. Another plant is Peperomia obtusifolia. And I have two of them. One is variegated one, another is simple one. And just look at them, they're just gorgeous, right? And I'm sorry for all the dust on the leaves. Currently, almost all of my plants standing in my balcony. And as you may know, I live in Lithuania and it's spring right now here, and all of the trees are blooming. So all of the pollen, I think you call it, this yellow dust from the blooms comes all over the place. So I clean the leaves once a week and it's still not working, because in about 1 hour or two they're already in yellow dust. But okay, that's another story. So that's the Peperomia obtusifolia, and they're so easy to grow. They're just like succulents. I water them once or in a week or once in 2 weeks, it depends on the weather. And both of them stands in the balcony. This one stands on the full sun in north window, so there's no burns. It's perfectly happy. And this one stands not on the full sun, it gets not direct sun. And it's also in the north window. And as you see, they're both happy, both crunchy. So they're very easy to take care of. They need a little bit more sun than the euphorbia that I showed before, but come on, I mean, all of us can find a corner where there's a little bit more sun, or we can choose a grow light, right? And these plants won't let you down, because they're very easy, very beautiful. And I'm thinking maybe one day I will just pot them in the same pot and it'll just look cute, right? heard that this plant is called Queen of Thorns, but actual name of this plant is Euphorbia millet, and this one is just amazing. It's so easy to take care of, just like a cacti. You can water it once a week or once in 2 weeks and it will be perfectly fine. It doesn't get lots of sun. It stands on my north window, so you know, there's not lots of sun. There's only full sun for 2 hours in the morning, and at this time in the morning I sleep, so I just have my curtains on, so there's no direct sun at all to this plant, and it's perfectly fine. It's happy and healthy. It has new growth coming up, and as you see, it's blooming pretty beautiful, at least in this label, right? So if you love cacti and if you love palms, but you're pretty afraid to start growing plants, palms, because, well, for me, they still don't work, you can always choose this Euphorbia because it's so beautiful. I love how dark leaves are, right? So dark and beautiful. And other side of leaves are this burgundy, this, I don't know, this cherry color. So it's beautiful. And it's really, really deserves a place on your windowsill. Okay, another plant you already have seen on my channel if you have been watching my videos. And this is this Maranta Fascinator. I have two of them. And they're just amazing. I mean, look at the colors. It's just so cute. It reminds me of scarabs, of peacocks. I don't know, just gorgeous plant. And what I love about them, that their leaves also shows you when it needs water. So this plant needs a little bit more water than all the plants I showed you before. And I water it twice a week, so it's a little bit more tricky one, and I also mist with water it a couple days, couple times a week, and it's perfectly happy. There's no browning on the leaves, and actually it stands on a shelf, and the shelf is very high, so there is no direct sun at all in any days, so it doesn't get lots of sun, and it's perfectly happy, perfectly fine. As you can see, there's lots of there's new leaves growing. This one is new, just unrolled. And what I love about this prayer plant, that it is actually praying. Even though there's not lots of sun in my room, still at daytime he looks like this, and at nighttime. Sorry. And at night time the leaves turn up and shows like yoo-hoo. So this is a beautiful plant. It's very easy to take care of, but just keep in mind that you will have to water it twice a week at least, because it's like a little bit more of moisture, and also but don't forget that it doesn't like to stand in water, so don't overwater it too much. Don't water it like more than two times a week for sure, unless you are living somewhere very hot. Well, that works for me. I water it twice a week. I sprinkle with water it like two times a week, maybe three times a week, whenever I remember to do it, and it's happy. So just keep in mind to have a drainage hole on your pot, so this plant will be happy. And you will be happy, because you will have such a beautiful plant, man. Just look at it. So beautiful. So last plant I want to share with you is this aloe. As you see, one I am holding in my hands, this beauty, and another one is standing in here. This one, you won't believe, is also found one. I saved this plant about a year ago, but it looks a little bit sad right now, because in winter months I left it in a very dark corner and there was no sun at all. I mean, it was a shady place. So it decided to throw all its leaves down. So the moment I saw that it is very, very unhappy, I just took it to the balcony, and right now it is growing beautiful new leaves and healthy ones, so I am pretty calm about this one. And this one is standing in the balcony also, and as you see right now, its color is a little bit like dusty purple and green and blue, and I don't know, it's just beautiful. But in winter months, when it doesn't get lots of sun, it's green. It's completely green, and it doesn't have this kind of a color. So I really love to wait until summer when it's standing in the sunny place, so it just changes its colors, and it's just beautiful for me. So this plant is so easy, you couldn't even imagine. You can water it twice a week in summer. Oh, yeah, Jesus Christ, I'm lying. I watered this aloe once in 2 weeks in summer months and once in a month in winter months. And it's completely fine and happy. It's growing new growth, as you can see from the inside. And I took a lot of babies from this plant. I think like 7 or 8 maybe when I got it. So it's just beautiful. And if you are looking for a plant that won't be just beautiful, you want some purpose out of it, the aloe is for sure 100% the one that you need, that you're looking for. There's so many uses of this plant, and it looks cute, right? It looks like a little dinosaur. So this one is actually one of my favorite ones, and it just looks cute, right? I mean, come on. So if you're looking for a plant that doesn't need more of lots of sun, I mean, it will be happy in lots of sun, but if you will put it in a darker corner, it won't die that quickly. I mean, this one stood in just in complete darkness. There was like 10 minutes of sun in its whole day, so that's why it's looking so sad. And this one stood in north facing room, not on the windowsill, but on my closed chest, in a little wardrobe. And it was completely fine, it looked happy, it doesn't die, any of its leaves wasn't unhealthy, all of them looks pretty the same as I got it, so that's an easy one for sure. And also, I forgot to tell you about feeding your plants. So all of these plants, I mean all of the plants I grow in my home, I feed them once a month, and I start to feed them from May and finish to feed them in about September or October. So in the warm months, once a month, I give them a little bit fertilizer, and it looks pretty fine. It's completely fine, I mean, but what I do, I water my plants day before I will fertilize them, so the roots will get a little bit of a water, and another day when I will fertilize it, the roots won't get a shock and they won't burn out of it. So I don't know how much does it work, but for now all of my plants looks completely happy and satisfied with this method, so I just keep doing it. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being with me. I hope this video was helpful and you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the like button and don't forget to subscribe for my channel, because lots of new plant videos are coming. So stay tuned, stay happy, stay green, and I'll see you next time. Bye!